As any TV viewer knows, real life crime is ugly, depressing and looks cool when it is in time for a thumping beat and a guitar solo. A good example is Dog the Bounty Hunter. It's currently showing on Bravo. It stars a man with a stupid haircut and it looks like this.
Bloody hell, McKenna Scrappers let herself go. First gloss, Dog the Bounty Hunter appears to be a bad 80s action movie starring a man who looks like Sir Alan Sugar impersonating a gay lion. But it's not a film, it's a docu-soap focusing on Dwayne the Dog Chapman. Dog and his family are just your average bunch of psychotic-looking biker types who live, love, laugh, and apprehend wanted criminals together. Most episodes consist of Dog and Co. tracking down a particular bail-jumping bad guy by following a familiar ceremony. First, a weekly group prayer.
Lord bless us as we go out today after this fugitive, and let us all remember that he does have a mother.
Then a depressing hunt as they wander around grim neighborhoods looking for tip-offs. The payoff consists of Dog and the rest of his pack flushing the criminal mastermind out. Not too hard, since most of the time the criminal mastermind is a bewildered junkie. Curiously, after a charming interlude in which Mr. Wrong is bundled to the floor and into the back of Dog's car, most of the crims turn out to be apologetic or relieved to be caught.
It's been a pleasure getting this way, gentlemen.
At which point, Dog does a quick bit of counselling like he's reading aloud from the Little Book of Calm.
It's pretty late in life to be doing what you're doing, but it's not too late to stop.
And then everyone's learned something and Dog can go home, back to his kennel, where presumably he licks his own balls before going to sleep, although they don't show that bit. Cowards.
I had a bounty on my head once. I was showing off in the newsagent. True story. Now, Frank, I happen to know that you really like Dog the Bounty Hunter.
I really love it. I watch it all the time. I think it's brilliant. There's a lot of love in Dog the Bounty Hunter. His family, they're all really, really close. All his family, they all go out together to catch him. And he's nice to the criminal. There's one... Because if the criminals all sort of like him, he's got this guy on the floor and he's got the cops on, and the bloke looks around at Dog and says, "Oh man, I watch you all the time."
Well, a lot of the time they're people who are on drugs, and I think that's going to help you get off drugs if you're on crystal meth and then suddenly Lion-O turns up. I'd do anything he says.
The thing is, he's a bounty hunter, but he's a bounty hunter in Hawaii. Like the softest place in the world. It's like CSI the Hay Literary Festival.
Tobay, what did you make of it?
I love it. I love its outrageous vulgarity. It is so incredible. The interesting thing to me is he doesn't see the criminal classes as distinct from himself. He is the same kind of person. But it's absurd. It is ridiculous. And I love it.
Can I just say, I'm really moved by that. This is the closest I'll ever get to seeing Dog the Bounty Hunter on Newsnight Review.
He's an incredibly conspicuous character, isn't he? For someone who's on the trail of people. How would you describe him to the police? If he committed a crime?
I think he looks like the Hell's Angel Les Battersby.
He's kind of a glam, heavy metal, biker, ballerina, god-botherer.
He looks like Sid James if he joined Bon Jovi.
do you know what he looks like? Do you know the Native Americans would wear the skin of the animal they were hunting? So they'd wear a wolf skin or something like that? He looks like Hulk Hogan has gone out to hunt Noel Edmonds. Wearing Noel.
I'm going to give you a point just for that description. Well done, Frankie. That's a point to you.
Okay.
Dog isn't just a bounty hunter, however. He's also a philosopher. Here are some of his deeper moments.
This is the life of crime. There's no bucket at the end of this rainbow. There's no reward, and there's no awards.
When I ended up in prison in 1977, I looked out, and all I could see was fields and fields of cotton. Until you're ready to admit smoking dope ain't cool, you're going to see a lot of cotton.
Instead of starting at the top of the mountain to work our way down, we're starting at the bottom and work our way up. And you know, if you take the bottom out of a mountain, the top falls. A little bit of hope and a little bit of hope and a little bit of hope adds up to a lot of hope. You do have hope for her. I, you know, hope against hope.
you know, hope against dope. I do have hope for her.
Why drugs there very much a little wrapped in enigma, draped in bullshit.
Yeah, I love those bits. He's an urban philosopher who loves his prey.
The thing is, he's a performance. He's not a reality.
I
think it's a pretty groovy performance.
I would imagine that, frankly, you have a less rosy view of his philosophy than you.
No, I always quite like that. I think Americans, where they'll sort of spout wisdom without necessarily having to be wise. They'll just go, well, I'll have a go at it.
Life is a lot like trees.
And they just, you know, they just try and find an end to the sentence and, yeah, take that away, buddy.
I find it really heartening that everybody really likes gold.
So isn't it when he's really anti-drugs, and there's some good anti-drug stuff in it, and the theme tune is sung by Ozzy Osbourne? It's like the theme to Last of the Summer Wine being sung by Harold Shipman.
Here's a question for you. Don published his autobiography in 2007. What was it called?
Was it called Somebody Else Must Have Written This? I mean, look at me.
No, that would be a startlingly frank title. No.
Was it called Looking for a Lead?
Was it Hard as Nails, Tales of Jails, Bells and Fruit-Based Cocktails?
No!
It was called You Can Run, But You Can't Hide.
It was, well done, Jermaine.